Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Jess from Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. In today's video, we're gonna be talking about the five things that you will see in the order that you will see them right before what you set intention for actually manifests. These are the things that I see time and time again in my own journey and also for you guys and for my clients. But remember, everyone is different, so you might have a little variation as far as the order that these things occurred for you or to you, but either way, it's pretty much stays quite the same. The first thing that you will notice right before or right as something is about to manifest, what actually gives it the power to allow it to manifest, is an extreme, I don't want to say extreme, but a really strong sense of excitement and enthusiasm. The reason why this is because your spirit, your soul, your higher self gets so stoked at the fact that you finally found the thing that it is that it's been wanting and calling out for. Not only have you found it, but you found it at the right time, so your spirit will soar. It's really important that you take that excitement and you take it seriously, because a lot of people will actually see and feel that excitement and just kind of like poo-poo it. They'll put it off to the side, or they'll allow distractions and other things in their everyday life to pull them away from the thing that sparked joy and pleasure and excitement in their life. In order for something to actually manifest, you have to feel it in your bones, deep in your bones, that it is yours, that it's meant for you. And as soon as your soul and your spirit recognizes it as truth, naturally, it gets excited. You'll then take that energy, that enthusiasm, that excitement, you'll channel it, you'll write it down. Then you'll find that talking about it, maybe even out loud to yourself or to friends or to a stranger, gets you even more excited, because your spirit's like, yes girl, or yes boo, you got this, this is yours. Now that's the first thing that you'll notice right before something manifests. And the reason why I started off with that is because it's the excitement itself that helps to ignite the energy so that it can actually come in and seed itself in your life. Now the second thing that you'll notice is that after the excitement, there's kind of like a brooding phase. That's what I'm gonna call it. This is when the energy around you really starts to get quiet. And for some people, that's when things can get a little weird. Because you had so much excitement when you originally set the intention, and when you originally felt the resounding truth that this thing truly is going to manifest and that it is manifesting, the silence and the quiet can be the freakiest part of the journey and of manifestation, because you're like, did I do something wrong? How come I don't feel that same excitement anymore? Do you remember how I said in the beginning that it's the excitement that kind of sparks and ignites the energy to kind of draw in and pull in what it is that you're going to manifest? The reason why that is because that is masculine energy. That is the act of doing, because masculine energy wants to do. You may have not seen with your own eyes the physical, actual material manifestation, but before you can do that, that thing that you're so excited for, that thing that you want and ignites you, has already been created. When your spirit senses that and picks up on it, it then sends a signal to your intuition, to your higher self, to ask you to ask for it. So masculine energy is the first thing to arrive, because he says, okay, I'm gonna roll my sleeves up, let's do what we gotta do, because that's what masculine energy wants to do, is to do the do. What do I have to do? Now that's the masculine part of it, and then we have the feminine. The feminine part is quiet, it's passive, and it wants to receive, and it's going to do that in the womb, in the quiet space, essentially in the void. This is the part that we struggle with the most as a society and as a collective, for a lot of us, because we feel like if we're going to set intention and this thing is going to manifest, we feel like we have to do something. But the reality is that we've already done what we needed to do when we set the intention in the first place. I know that that's a lot to wrap your mind around, but what I really want you to grasp from both of those things, from both of those things that I've already said, is that the thing that it is that you are setting intention for, that you want to manifest, or that you're working to manifest, you have to realize that it's already manifested, it just needs to materialize. That's why number one is the actual excitement that it is that you feel, and then you feel that call and you respond to it by actively doing. Once that excitement is felt and that intention is put out there, that's when we go into the void, the quiet, the silent, the stillness, and we allow ourselves to receive. That quiet space is so important because it's in that quiet space that there's a void and emptiness. The universe senses this and then works in order to fill it. When it pours masculine and feminine energies in, those two separate entities come together and something will be created and be physically born into our reality and actually materialize. When that thing actually starts to materialize, that is going to move us on to step number three. Now, this is when something actually is being created and we can stir ourselves back to life again. And how we'll know that this is what's happening is because this is inspired action. All of a sudden, we're creative, we're inspired, we feel like, oh, I'm just gonna go here because I want to, because it's fun, because I feel called to. That inspired action is a direct result of the first step, which is the excitement, the second step, which is the void. And because of those two things, something is created, you sense it, you're open to it, and you respond to it. The universe will then help to direct you and move you if you're allowing yourself to flow. However, if you are rigid and too stern and structured in your thinking of how things should be or could be or the way that they will manifest, you're gonna lock yourself up and delay the process. That is a person who is uncomfortable in the void space, in the feminine energy, in the art of receiving. Now the fourth step and the fourth thing that you'll notice after you are doing the creative, inspired action is you're gonna start seeing synchronistic signs and coincidences. Now pretty much what this is the universe being like, yep, look over here. Yep, this is another sign. Yep, this is what it is. Yep, this is confirmation. What I want you to do is to continue to stay open and to continue to stay in that creative flowing energy. This is where a lot of you guys kind of messed up because you wanna go right to the first step and step into masculine energy where you wanna be like, okay, well, what do I have to do? I received this synchronistic sign. I received this confirmation. What do I do with it? That's very masculine energy. You wanna stay in a space of balance so that you are allowing your energy and your creative sparks and the universe to flow through you to guide you. Stay in that void space. Stay in the openness. Allow yourself to flow and work with that creative inspiration, that inspired action. And number five, the final thing that you will notice when your intention is manifesting is its actual physical appearance in your life, in the material form that you can touch it and you can feel it and be like, finally, it is here. It has arrived. It manifests, it's there, it presents itself. I'm telling you guys, this is what it's like. Anything that you're setting intention for will manifest. It's like a cycle, we see it again and again. And the only thing that will ever truly trip you up is essentially kind of yourself when you start fighting the flow instead of going with the flow. Now, I will say that there are some things that simply will not manifest and there are signs that will tell you that they won't. If you'd like to see a video on that, let me know down in the comments. But until then, make sure that you're subscribed to my YouTube channel because there's plenty more videos where this came from, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.